Hey friends, somebody I knew died at the end of last year. His name was Baron Wolman. He was a very well-known, legendary photographer, particularly known for his work with Rolling Stone magazine. He was actually the head photographer for the first 3 years of its publication, and he shot Woodstock, Jimi Hendrix, The Doors, Janis Joplin, you know, all the luminaries of that era. And he did it in like a very naturalistic, vibrant way. He wasn't into fantasy or made up scenarios, studio lighting, any of that stuff. He went for the raw emotion that you get from performers. And after he left Rolling Stone, he founded a fashion magazine. He shot for the NFL. And he got into aerial photography as a result of shooting for the NFL and being in the blimps. And he's just done a ton of stuff in his life. But he was an internet friend of mine. I think in 2021, we can say that internet friends count just as much as your in real life friends. He was very, very supportive of me on Instagram. We DM'd a lot over the last couple years. And he commented on the majority of my photos. And when you're an artist and somebody who has a lot of experience and clout and is a legend and somebody whose work you really, really respect and like, believes in you, that means an awful lot. I started shooting in Ohio towards the end of last year, and Baron was from Columbus, Ohio, and he left pretty hysterical comments and about the wild women of Ohio. Where were they when he was young? We had talked about meeting up in person, and he died at 83. He died of ALS, which is a neurological disorder that my own mother actually passed away from. It's a very rare disease. Stephen Hawking is the most well-known person who had ALS, and once you get it, it's pretty terminal. It's weird that Stephen Hawking lived as long as he did, but in the case of my mother, there was nothing that could have been done to stop her from passing away from it. Shortly before Baron died, I picked up his book, The Rock and Roll Revolution. Even though it's a square, other than that, it's got the texture and feel of a vinyl record. It has a lot of his greatest hits from that Rolling Stone era, and it has like really cool psychedelic design to go with it. So few of us actually make work that lasts a long period of time, and work that's genuinely meaningful to people. And I mean, that's kind of one of my overriding goals, is to make something that transcends the Instagram algorithm feed like cycle. I want to make things that connect with people. And I feel like that's where Baron and I kind of overlapped, because naturalistic approaches and going for like genuine emotion and gesture over calculated, completely set up in the studio type of work. Maybe that's why he thought I was worthy of his time. I mean, we talked about things beyond photography. He took the personality test that I'm so into. He's an INFJ, one of the rare male INFJs. There aren't that many out there. But I just felt like I should make a video about Baron.
When I got my first camera, I was 15 years old. Yeah. And I feel like I married that camera that day. And for 60 years, because I'm old, 75 years old. And I feel like I've been married to that camera the whole time. And it's been my best friend throughout all these years. What happened to me is that before I had a camera, I looked out at the world and it was very chaotic. There was noise, visual noise, chaos. I picked up the camera and I could frame the moment that was important to me, and everything quieted down, and I began then to see the world to communicate with people, the world that I saw.
You hear about this a lot in the past, where maybe like a writer or musician caught the eye and caught the attention of one of their heroes, and they kept up a correspondence with them, and maybe they never met in person. I feel like social media today is no different. There are a lot of people I talk to on a near daily basis, and I've never met them in real life. But they mean a lot. And, Baron was a good friend. So just want to make a little video in tribute to him, maybe continue spreading awareness of his work, because even though the artist passes on, the art remains and they're immortal through it. So thanks for watching. Talk to you next time.